across 14th Street, essentially shutting down traffic to keep people safe, and because people have been throwing things at each other as well as at police in the street. So this has become a very dangerous situation, and as we show you what it looks like inside Union Square Park, you see all that looks like debris on the ground. There was construction happening near the 14th Street station here, and there was paint cans as well as buckets, all sorts of construction equipment that was being thrown about. So you see the paint in the street there, and at the station where that roof, the gazebo, is covering it, we had people actually climbing onto the top. Police actually got control of that portion of the crowd, but we also had people up on the statue here at the south side of the park, and in fact, you can see they have overtaken this once again. This is normally completely barricaded off, but the crowd here is just taking over the area, so police picking and choosing what they are dealing with here, but a massive crowd, several thousand people strong, unruly at times, and at times we're seeing them run randomly in different directions. So we'll bring up Street Spotter 7 here so you can see. If you are on the east side of Union Square Park, you've got the cars literally swarmed by people there. Same thing happening occasionally on the west side, but 14th Street essentially closed off as police tried to gain the upper hand on this massive crowd again. Kai Sanat, a Twitch streamer, saying he was going to show up at 4 o'clock. It is now 4:02. We have not seen him yet, but to give away free PlayStations, and that is what caused this massive crowd. It was announced yesterday. He reminded people on Instagram today that he was coming at 4, and police really trying to gain the upper hand on this situation. For now, they've got 14th Street closed. Police aviation overhead as well, trying to help with the crowd control, but massive crowds, and they are swarming into different areas and then spreading out sporadically throughout Union Square Park. But look, imagine what it would be like if you were in this car, you were trying to travel south on the east side of Union Square, and you were just swarmed by people. So if you can avoid this area, do it at all costs. This is a dangerous situation with people that are completely out of control. Reporting live over Union Square Park, Shannon Soane, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
I have seen some crazy stuff, but this...
live streaming on Instagram from the center of that crowd down there, which is probably why we saw all of a sudden that crowd suddenly converge when we went to you at the top of our show. But we have been seeing for the better part of about a half hour, 40 minutes, we think that's him in the bright green all the way in the center there. But that is a very dangerous situation, considering how many people there and the force of that crowd moving along. And you can see he's kind of encouraging them.
Yeah, you know, he is encouraging them, and I'm a little bit worried about all of this in general, because before he even got here, the crowd was really converging on each other, and it would break out into a bit of a fight. Every time the crowd got really close to each other, things would start to get thrown. They would back away, and then they would come back together again. Now, regardless of what's happening here, he's saying he's giving away PlayStations. I doubt he has PlayStations for all these people, if he has any at all. So what's going to happen when one or two or ten, I don't know how many he's giving away, but however many he's giving away are given away, and people are going away empty-handed. That's also going to be another factor in this. But anytime you get a crowd together like this, where it's not planned really far in advance, and something big is happening, they're getting downright rowdy down below, and there's just not enough police officers to control the crowd. And what you see, like, you're right, I think that is him right in the middle of your picture, but we've seen this happen several times. We're just going to bring the camera out for a minute. You see him, and you're right, streaming on social media. You see his arm going up with his phone, but you've got another crowd off to the right side, so they might be wondering where he is, if he's even there yet. But this is an enormous crowd, and just not nearly as many police officers as there are people in Union Square.
And we should probably mention one of the reasons there's likely not more police officers on site is because they had no idea. This was not a planned event. I mean, unless you were on social media paying attention to his post, they would know about this. And I suppose what they're doing now is trying to block that traffic on 14th Street, and then they didn't have an opportunity to do so over there. I think that's Park Avenue South that runs along the eastern side of Union Square there. So I'm sure
this can't end well.
To anyone that's going to be
this cannot end well.
Part of Manhattan. Oh, and these are pictures on the ground we're looking at right now. The rowdy crowd. We said earlier interaction with police was not what you would like to see. They appear to be throwing objects at the officers that are on the scene. The challenge right now is to try and get a hold of that crowd, get some control of that crowd, and make some sense of it.
Right. And you could see the police were really overwhelmed in those moments as they were throwing things at them, and you could see police retreat. The interesting thing, and the question I think many people are wondering now, is what is police strategy going to be right now in terms of trying to control this unwieldy crowd that they were caught off guard? It's clearly not a permitted event that they were able to prepare.
Look at them standing on the people's cars.
That just suddenly appeared.
This is not going to end well.
And I just want to show you, before, just a few minutes ago, we showed you those cars parked, or actually not parked. They were trying to get through Union Square East. And now, not only are they stopped, which is what we showed you before, but now there are people actually standing on top of those cars. So these are people that were caught, literally, as you said, in a flash mob. And now people are standing on their cars. And this is exactly the kind of thing that police officers are trying to gain control of, because this has just become a dangerous situation at this point. And as this crowd really starts to come around to Kai Sanaa, you're going to see that this crowd off to the right side is going to start to merge in with that crowd in the middle. And all of that is happening on the southeast side of Union Square Park. So that's 14th Street here in the middle of your picture. And all of these cars were just trying to cross over 14th Street. Now, as much as police have been overwhelmed, we've also caught glimpses of them trying to sort of soothe people that sort of got stuck in the middle of this. We saw one police officer trying to guide a bicyclist through this to get him out of harm's way, while all the while, some people in the crowd were throwing water bottles and buckets at the police officers. But imagine what this must feel like. You were traveling south, going towards East 14th Street, and people are now standing on the top of your car trying to get a better look at Kai Sanaa for what, again, you mentioned was an unplanned event that attracted thousands and thousands and thousands of people, with police officers not at the ready for something like this to happen.
So, Shannon, I have to ask you, considering the size of this crowd, and honestly, it appears to be growing there, and I did see more people tossing. What impact is this having on those streets and that traffic around there? Union Square, especially this time of the day, really busy.
We're
trying to find this
guy. It's basically stopped everything. We'll bring up Street Spotter 7 for you so you can get an idea. Union Square West is on the right side of your picture. Union Square East on the left side. And 14th Street now completely shut down.
That's what I'm looking.
I don't think that police have the capacity at this point to even close the traffic further north here. So I'm going to just bring you down.
Kai Sanaa?
And we'll look at it together, actually, for the first time. I don't think they've managed to close the streets because all of their attention right now is focused on the crowd control. So it's incumbent on you to know that this is happening and to try and stay away.
Trying to put it in Google and it's giving me high Senate.
On Union Square East or Union Square West, obviously 14th Street is closed with the people here, but police don't even have enough manpower at this point to close off the street. So the people who are stuck in that traffic further back, the best thing that they can do is veer off and stay away from this at all costs. Now, you do see people kind of walking through the area. Some of these people are just crowds that happen to have been in Union Square, and now they are stuck in, and I think
I hope those retail workers lock the doors, you know? I really hope they lock the doors.
Starting to fan out, but no matter how you look at it, there are just too many people here and not enough police officers. So 14th Street, for the foreseeable future, is going to be shut down because all police want to do at this point is gain control of the crowd. I think at this point, traffic is sort of secondary. Now, you can see the police officers here. When we first got on the scene, there were maybe 30 of them. And now there are so many that it's hard to sort of discern them between the crowds of people and which ones are officers. Some of them are very obvious because they're setting up a perimeter and trying to keep people away. But at points, there are police officers in the middle of the crowd as well. So an interesting situation for sure. stuck in these cars, and now they're jumping from one vehicle to another. It has to be terrifying to be down there if that's not what you wanted to do. Now, I think we've got some tape that we can show you from earlier before Kai Cenat arrived on the scene. So I'm hoping they'll be able to roll that for you. But we're going to show you where this was taken. Right in this area of Union Square Park, you can sort of see on the ground, there's paint splatter everywhere. Now it's really being covered up by crowds. But crowds were, like, merging in on each other and literally throwing bottles and buckets. And it looked like a total mess here. And I want to bring you back to these live pictures to show you. I told you earlier at the subway station there were people up on the roof. Police were able to clear that for a little
shit.
While, but now they are going back up. Originally,
sorry
they were
for
using
the
ladder. Now they've got people up on the roof, and they're holding out hands for other people and just pulling them up onto the roof of the subway station at 14th and Union Square. So they did manage to get the ladder away from them, and presumably that ladder was there for the construction happening in this area. But the crowds are trying to get up on the roofs of this. They're trying to get up onto the statue over here. Now, a few minutes ago, we showed you the statue, and the crowd was gathered around this. Now we've got some people up on the statue, but a lot of that crowd has dispersed. So it is moving around a bit, but it is also filling in, which is just a scary prospect here. Again, police aviation overhead trying to get a handle on this too, and trying to position police officers where they need them. But I keep being drawn back to this picture here, where people were trying just to get through traffic, and now people climbing on top of their cars to the point where you almost can't see the vehicles.
Yes, Shannon, we are getting some information now that six trains are right now bypassing the 14th Street Union Square station in both directions, obviously in deference to what's going on there. And you mentioned that where we saw the people up on the roof there, that has been under construction. So that added danger of what has been a construction area for weeks now. That's that big entrance to the train station right there in Union mm-hmm. Square Park. Probably why they were able to find a ladder around there. And I'm assuming the workers, once they started seeing the crowds and stuff, kind of dispersed themselves.
Yeah, I think that's absolutely the case. And you're seeing right here an arrest being made by police officers. But look at the chairs that are strewn about. So chairs were being thrown. They're trying to put up barricades. But as people try to get through those barricades, police are now making arrests through this area. And we talked about that gazebo over the 14th Street station. You know, it's under construction. That's a fear in and of itself. But it's not intended to hold human body weight on top of it. That's not its purpose. So this is a whole nother problem that could evolve because of this completely chaotic crowd. I mean, that is literally the only way to describe a crowd like this. And they're all looking for something free. Who knows if they're going to get it at the end, and who knows what that is going to look like when this is all said and done.
Right. And Shannon, even though we had heard that Kai Cenat had been streaming live from down in that crowd, at this point, we don't even know if he's still down there, do we?
No, we don't. You know, I'm trying to look for that green shirt again, and the crowd is just so thick, it's hard to make it out. So we genuinely don't know, but how he would get out of this crowd at this point is a question as well. I can't even imagine how he would work his way out. I don't even think police officers would be able to get to him to help him out if that's what he needed at this point. It is just a mob scene down below.
Right, and it does not seem like he walked into that crowd with his own private security who could potentially help him navigate his way out of that situation. We are starting to hear that there have been some NYPD officers who have suffered some injuries. We have no idea at this point the extent of those injuries. I would imagine, considering the atmosphere down there, that we are going to start to hear about injuries. Police as well as those who are there in the crowd.
Oh, I would absolutely think so. But you can see things have certainly changed on the police front. You were looking down at 14th Street now, and you see the line of officers here, where when we first arrived on the scene and officers were first arriving on the scene, what we saw was truly remarkable. You saw a group of officers, maybe 10 or 15, and they were actually holding plywood over their heads. And they actually took cover behind some of the cars that were stuck on 14th Street as the crowd approached them, throwing things at them. I mean, it was something I've not trying to get some sort of order here, but there's a significantly more police presence now, and it does look like there are...
And with this, an ambulance can't even get through. If people really got hurt, an ambulance can't get through.
They can tell them where they need to be. But again, I keep being drawn back to these cars. The first few cars here have now virtually disappeared in this group of cars.
And when you think about it, those police officers probably had to get on the subway to get there. I don't know what precinct is near there where they could walk. They probably had to get on the subway.
So you got to believe that reinforcements are pouring in there. We see that with the officers now lining 14th Street there. They're going to need a whole lot more officers if there are any hopes of trying to bring some order to this situation. Although people, it appears they've moved out of the park. That's
and
that really open space
down
to the street.
Towards the street.
Yeah, they seem to be moving, but we've seen this happen a few times.
Oh, look at the workers up on the roof here.
We've been here for probably,
I guess they did lock the doors
too. And for a while, it almost seems like a pack mentality where someone sees someone move and they run aggressively in a direction and a whole group of them run with them. So it might not actually mean anything. We were watching some go from the south side of Central or Union Square Park. I keep saying Central Park. From Union Square Park, and they were running towards the north. And then they would just sort of double back and head back into the fray. So I'm not sure if it's a mob mentality where you see people going and you think that you must be intended to go in that direction as well. But that's what we're seeing again going down Broadway here. They're literally just moving along, not quite sure what's on the other side of that. I'm actually going to see if Captain Randy can move a little bit to the right for me so that we can look down the street a little bit and see what's causing
but
this. This is something we've been seeing where they'll run aggressively in a direction, and it just seems like some people see them running and they're like, well, we should do that too.
Oh my God, the hot dog vendors are stuck there.
So we're not quite sure what is causing them to do that, but we've been seeing this in various different directions throughout this last 45 minutes or so.
You got to believe for a lot of these people,
those are residential buildings
really
right there.
It's a happening.
So there's doormen and maintenance people. I hope they have that secured.
Oh,
Mayor Adams, you better arrest this guy. You got to arrest him, Mayor Adams.
Twitch streamer,
a social media influencer. He has 20 million followers. He asked them all to come meet him here at Union Square for what was a PlayStation 5 giveaway at 4 o'clock. Apparently, we're also hearing that people showed up only to find out there were no freebies. And as you heard, he is here. At one moment, he was live streaming in a van nearby, but he did step out. As you heard, he's out here greeting his fans. We even observed Chief of Department Jeff Madry out here having objects thrown at him. Cops are obviously outnumbered out here. They're standing back for the most part. We're hearing that there are officers who have been injured, unclear at this hour, the extent and severity of injuries. But, you know, we're also seeing paint left over from this construction project near this entrance that's been tossed around and vandalized. Some of the equipment at the entrance here. As we made our way towards this area, there are many, many streets around here closed. Police officers, we noticed, closed off traffic as high as 20th Street. Trains are skipping this subway station now, so police are asking everyone to avoid this area. But as you can see, there is a large, large crowd here. We're hearing estimates of thousands and thousands of people who showed up. And clearly, NYPD is vastly outnumbered in the situation. So
I wonder if that's his car. That's him on top with the green, right?
Safwan was saying he was there. He was in the crowd for a little bit of time, but clearly this was an out-of-control crowd. And so no freebies given away, no giveaway whatsoever getting in the car. But clearly you're looking at a very dangerous situation with this car now driving pretty fast with those people clinging on to the side and top of it. It's mind-boggling why they're not stopping to let these people off the car. And then, and then there just fell, someone fell off.
Okay, shit.
Joining us now is Bob Boyce, former NYPD, to talk more about this situation. Bob,
look,
can you hear
falling
Liz,
off.
Joe and Sandra Bookman?
I can, but like it's true.
Okay, we know you're on the phone. I don't know if you have an opportunity to see what's going on in Union Square, but talk to us a little bit about police procedure. Obviously, this was a situation that police were not expecting. So how is it that they start getting the upper hand in crowd control here?
So they call a level 3 mobilization. That's citywide. But there's going to be calls from every precinct in the city coming there. They have to stage first, and they have to get together, and then they have to, at some point, go in and disperse the crowd. Now, someone should be on a bullhorn right now dispersing this crowd. I don't know if they're doing that yet, but that's usually what happens. Generally speaking, they'll bring it mounted to aid in that effect, and they'll start diffusing the crowd as best they can. It looks like you have an unruly mob right now, and they have to bring order to it. But citywide units are coming. In the meantime, they'll have to do with the best they can what they have.
How much of a challenge is this for law enforcement? Look, we've seen similar things on the Jersey Shore. Somebody sends out an announcement on social media that there's going to be a party. The next thing you know, you've got 3,000 people on a beach at 11 o'clock at night. This seems like a similar thing. We're giving away freebies in Union Square at 4 o'clock, and the next thing you know, 5,000-6,000 people show up. They're not getting the freebies, so they start acting out. How difficult is it for the department to get a handle on this and keep it from turning into a kind of free-for-all?
Mm-hmm. We've lost Bob Boyce. He is on the phone. We're going to try to reestablish our connection with him because, obviously, there are a lot of questions. Bob is back. Bob, can you hear us?
I can.
Did you get any of that question? You know, these calls going out on social media, obviously, young people know it's out there. They got the message. They're showing up at 4 for something free. 5,000 other people show up. The police are sort of almost behind the eight ball. How difficult is it for the department to keep track of these things and to try to bring some order to the situation and keep it from becoming a free-for-all like we've seen here in Union
Square? And
those
folks are following him on the motorcycle. Well, that's what's happening here in NYC today.